Hello folks, before we dive into this video, our sponsor for February 2020 is Zoho Suite. Now Zoho Suite is a range of products covering sales to help desks to email and much more. They wanted us to focus in on one of their products, which is Zoho Projects. Now Zoho Projects is a way for your team to manage projects and work in and out of the office. They have features like task management, time tracking, charts, reports, including Gantt chart abilities, plenty of issue tracking features for bugs, and also Zoho Analytics integrations too. With success stories from construction industries to software development, it's a popular place to bring all of your projects into one place. So thanks to Zoho Suite for sponsoring this month on Keep Productive. So, are you looking at Todoist and maybe a little curious about whether Todoist Free is worth it? Or maybe you're looking to recommend it to someone and they don't necessarily have the money to upgrade? In today's video, we're going to take a look at the Todoist plans. We're going to be specifically focusing in on the free plan, giving you all you need to know, and I guess a little bit of a value overview to see whether it's actually worth downloading and utilizing in the free version. Maybe it will give you a bit of an idea about the application. And near the end, we'll also compare it to applications like TickTick, which also have a free plan, and which give you an idea of what the two comparisons of these two major Todoist applications look like. So let's start with the three Todoist plans. There are three Todoist plans. The first is Todoist Free, which is of course no money per month. Todoist Premium, which is priced at $3 per month per user, and that is billed annually, which rounds up to $36 per year. You also have Business, which is a little bit more expensive, but is more tailored towards business customers with a team inbox and also some additional administration abilities. We won't be focusing too much on that today. Now, some of the main features of the free account are up to 5 people, allowing up to 5 people per project in your workspace, and up to 80 projects in total being active inside of your Todoist account. Now, inside of the premium, you do get 300 projects, which is definitely much more. Get 220 additional projects to be able to manage, and you'll also get an additional 20 people per project if you wanted to invite them along. So let's take a look at the free version. I actually started up a new account because I'm actually a premium user. So take that in mind, maybe a slight bias towards the application, but I'll explain a little later in this video. So looking at the free version, the first pros are the priorities. So you do still get access to adding priorities. You can add P1, P2, P3, and still be able to add that. You can also add recurring items, which is very handy if you have routine items, for example this one like pay off credit card, and you can also set that to any of the intelligent input days. For example, let's say you wanted it every 15th of the month, you can just type in every 15th and it will automatically detect that. The same goes to if you were quickly typing in tomorrow at 3 p.m. it would also detect that. So intelligent input is a freemium feature. One of the other things that the Todoist free account offers is integrations. You can connect up with, for example, Google Calendar and a few other abilities, especially with other applications. I know apps like Toggle and other apps such as this are quite good at being able to connect up with Todoist. Now, of course, the free account does have some limitations when it comes to obviously not paying. Obviously, you have the limit of 80 projects, and it definitely will probably cover you for the first couple of years, in my opinion, and up to 5 people. If you're using it on your own, you probably won't end up using it. So in a personal, daily use context, you're probably not going to meet those categories. There are also no limitations to the amount of subtasks that you can add. For example, here we get starting adding a few subtasks, and it seems to be no problem in the free account with no limitations to have to worry about. There are some obviously limitations when it comes to features. Reminders is a big one. A lot of people don't like actually not having a nudge, for example, inside of their account when there is a reminder set. You can set reminders through the web or SMS, or even through your mobile, which give you nudges about your application. Now, you also get the ability to upload comments and file upload when you're in premium. So that's something that if you commonly do, maybe add notes or even be able to add files to a certain task, that's something that you're going to miss out on. One of the other big things that a lot of people upgrade to Todoist Premium is labels and filters, and you don't get that inside of your Todoist free account. You can, for example, write at finance next to something, but it won't be able to detect it and won't be able to filter inside of labels. Now, a few things to clear up. There are some pre-created filters in there for you. So, for example, if you did want to, you know, get started with a few filters that they provide, then that's awesome because they've got a few there. But if you look to go and create some, then that's where you're not allowed to do it. And the same goes with labels. You won't be able to get access to that left-hand panel. One of the things I do like about Todoist Free is that it actually, from the old days, it doesn't actually give you that sort of bar at the top, this is Todoist Free, sort of annoying you. I actually haven't seen that since using it in the last sort of hour, which is good, and they normally pop up in the first hour pushing you towards premium. I'm sure I'll get an email in a week or so, but at the same time it's not as aggressive as it once was. So there are a few other things. For example, inside of the free account you can't set up the productivity trends, which I believe is the karma base point, so you can't actually see your graphics which come out there. You also won't be able to access the premium themes, which is something a lot of people like to do. You can't also access backups, which is actually an option that appears in the settings page, which is ideal for people who want to store regular backups of their Todoist account. There is also the inability to add tasks via email. This is a premium feature which allows you to email in tasks into a certain project inside of each project. So if you're someone that likes to create templates and also import and export them, you won't be able to do that inside of Todoist Free. However, you are able to use some of the templates that are pre-created by Todoist and actually get them imported directly into your Todoist account. So that's handy if you definitely want to skip by that and just utilize some of the template gallery that they have available. So two more things. The priority support is not available when you're using the Todoist Free. For example, if you're looking to get a question answered by the team and you send a support message, chances are, because you're on Todoist Free, it won't be the fastest response, and that's just one of the benefits. Many applications do this as a way to sort of up the ante, make the premium a bit more worth the value. You also won't be able to access your activity list, which I think is very helpful. This activity log actually tracks the completed tasks, your deferred tasks, your updated tasks, uncompleted tasks per project, per person, which is all very useful, and something that I've particularly been using the last few weeks. Okay, let's compare this to a very big application that challenges Todoist, which is called TickTick. Now, first off, TickTick's premium is a little bit cheaper. It is $27.99 per year, and I believe you can bill yourself monthly if you want to make it a little bit cheaper, I guess, in the short term. Now, as you can imagine, TickTick is challenging Todoist to some extent with that pricing, but they do have a few limitations when it comes to their free experience. And they sort of reside around the limitations you have per list, per task, etc. So for example, you're only allowed up to 9 lists, which, like Todoist Free, 80 versus 9 seems extremely small. And within that list, you're only allowed to add up to 99 tasks, which I can imagine per project is a really big thing to worry about, because obviously you might be able to hit that and capture that quite fast. So again, 99 tasks per list seems a little bit small, and Todoist doesn't actually have a limitation to how many tasks you can add per project with those 80 projects in the free account. Looking at their subtasks as well, you're only allowed 19 per task. So I feel like once you get everything set up in TickTick, if you're using the free account and just don't want to go past that, and you sort of have 25 subtasks per task, because you want to break it down, that's going to be a sort of limitation for you, because obviously you're going to get the premium messages all the time. So looking at a few more metrics, you do get reminders per task, you get two per task, which is pretty good. So you do get the reminders ability, which a lot of people like to have, especially when they're looking to get themselves nudged about a task that's coming up. And you do get one attachment per day, which is fairly reasonable. You do miss out on the members per list. You get two members per list. So you do also only get two plans per week, and that's a feature that is unlimited inside a premium. Now, the premium obviously does unlock more. You can have 99 lists, 999 tasks, 199 subtasks, 5 reminders per task, 99 attachments, 19 members per list, and also unlimited plans per week, which is fairly good. And what I would say is that the TickTick Premium definitely unlocks more than what Todoist has, in my opinion. You get calendar view, and you also get the Kanban boards. You get per device like features. So for example, like the Android device has got the Pomodoro timer. You also got habit tracker as well. So there are some abilities that you do get above Todoist. And in my opinion, the premium themes are a lot better in the application. You do get, for example, a few more features like duration, and custom smart list, which is essentially filters in Todoist. So looking back at this, I would say that the Todoist free account is a lot better than the TickTick free account. It's definitely more like less limiting. For example, like you don't necessarily have to worry too much about like how many tasks you're adding, how many subtasks. And there are some really basic features that are available inside the Todoist free, which make it a lot easier to be able to use it for a longer period of time. Say you're bedding in for maybe 6 to 12 months in light use, you're probably going to be able to use Todoist free a lot more. The sort of bugaboo that a lot of people don't like is that it doesn't have reminders, and TickTick free would have reminders. But again, it's really dependent on what type of person you are. Now, I actually don't use the labels and filters as much as I do these days, and I actually don't use the comments and file upload that I do these days as well. And that's mainly because I have moved more of my tasks to the subtasks, which I'll probably do a feature on later in the year. And I also don't use reminders, so my work tends to fit more to Todoist free. But again, I like to support the application, and I also still use the labels in light use. I use the project trends as well as premium themes, auto backups, and occasionally the project templates, and definitely recently the activity log, which makes it a lot better for me. So guys, that was just a short overview of whether Todoist free is worth it. As you can imagine, it's really dependent on your experience. But again, I'd recommend this. I'd always recommend Todoist free for someone who's looking to get started with like a task management application for the first time, especially if you've got a friend that doesn't want to be sort of thrown into the deep end or maybe overly pushed into an aggressive task management strategy. You want to ease them in. I always recommend Todoist free as a great way to get started. So guys, hopefully that was useful. Let me know in the comments what you think about Todoist free. Is it worth it? Is it decent? But as you can imagine, I definitely think it is. Obviously the premium's worth it too. So hopefully today gave you a good overview. Again, I have a slight bias to be a Todoist user, but again, looking at like, I guess, looking at it like that, it makes it a lot sort of easier to sort of manage. And I did definitely spend a bit of time thinking about it too. Anyway, guys, thank you so much. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.